making waves in the field of youth empowerment and sustainability, reminding us of AI Gore's words. The climate crisis is not a political issue. It is a moral and spiritual challenge to all of humanity. Our next speaker, Ms. Ishanvi Shetty, is a student at GEMS Modern Academy in Dubai. Actively involved in sustainability initiatives, she hosts and participates in conferences, advocates and volunteers for the environment. With a keen interest in the intersection of climate change and AI, she aims to make a meaningful impact through her advocacy efforts. Please give a warm welcome to Ms. Ishanvi as she inspires us.
I'd like to thank Lotus Petal School and for this opportunity and for having me here. Right. So, our future. A 3 degrees Celsius rise in global temperatures above pre-industrial levels. Nothing much, right? I mean, if you had told me that 3 degrees Celsius could mean the end of the world, I'd probably have laughed in your face. But that's exactly what it could mean. A catastrophic point of no return. Unrelenting heat waves, hurricanes, fires, droughts, the collapse of vital natural ecosystems, millions starving. I think you get the picture. In short, on the path we're on, I think Interstellar paints quite the stellar picture of the future that awaits us. You see, 5 years ago, I was 10 years old, and I had just watched a video on climate change. Now, climate change to me was a sort of lingering threat somewhere in the future, as I'm sure it is for millions of people. But the urgency and appeal conveyed in that video made that moment like my awakening to the terrifying situation we were actually pulling ourselves into. And so as time went on, I started involving myself in various climate-related pursuits. And this journey of mine and my love for the environment and my passion for the fight against climate change, it stems from my love for nature and biodiversity. And it is that very love that has driven me to stand here in front of you all today and deliver this talk. I think, in fact, I hope that we can all agree that climate change is one of, if not the biggest issues humanity has ever faced. And our situation isn't getting much better. But I believe that the fundamental manner in which we view and approach the climate crisis is flawed. You see, I've always done what I've always been told to do. I've always switched off the lights, turned off the fan, recycled plastic, composted food waste. And yet, what I failed to realize is that there were much larger culprits of climate change hiding in the shadows. And while the media portrayed, of course, individual actions to be the problem, there were major industries that were going under the radar. Now, don't get me wrong, individual actions are crucial, not only in creating a positive impact on the environment, but in actually fostering a culture of sustainability and eco-consciousness. But they only make a small dent in the solving of the larger crisis. And what we do often ignore are the high-emission, boring industries, the non-glamorized aspects of climate change where the real impact lies. This is like cement, steel, aluminium, real estate. These are all the industries that don't receive nearly the amount of action or even attention that they require. And then there's the myth, the illusion of green and sustainable products where companies, they prey on consumers or customers like you and I, and they use the guise of sustainability to create the illusion of an impact, when in actuality, they aren't even targeting the systemic roots of the problem. And therein lies my personal beef with this issue. The gravity of the situation, it inevitably, I suppose, causes certain individuals and certain entities to exploit and commercialize the crisis, making it even harder for an individual like you and I who may want to make personal habit changes to track or even make a tangible impact. So what now? Is there nothing we can do? Do we just take a step back and pray? Well, the first thing we have to do is recognize the importance of systemic STEM-based solutions in targeting problems in hard-to-decarbonize sectors and industries over one-dimensional solutions. And we have to stop focusing on the small visual changes and start focusing on the real drivers of climate change, the industries that power our world. Now, The hard truth is that our focus on climate change is often misplaced. Let me give you a very simple example, right? The meat and dairy industry. Now, if I told you that the meat and dairy industry contributes to a staggering 14 to 20% of global emissions, I mean, this is a ginormous number, but I'm sure none of you are mind blown, because we all know about the impact of the meat and dairy industry on climate change. But what if I were to tell you that global production sectors, I'm talking about steel, I'm talking about cement, I'm talking about aluminium, these actually contribute to 54% of global emissions. And real estate, our buildings, our houses, not only do they contribute to around 40% of global emissions, they actually consume around 30% of our world's energy resources. And it's not only these industries, it's also shipping industry and fast fashion. Did you know that a single cotton shirt, like this one, takes around 3,000 liters of water to produce? Let that sink in, right? And then there's renewable energy. And while the awareness of climate change grows, we've come to question less and less the role of renewable energy in our crisis and focus more on its implementation. But experts themselves have come to question this role of renewable energy in our crisis. This is a still from the opening scene of a famous movie, Blade Runner 2049, and it shows a dystopian view of California's deserts being covered in solar panels, a very possible reality on the path we're on. And in fact, Ivanpah Valley is a solar project that's already started in California. And this project has led to the loss of biodiversity and habitat of this biodiversity on a massive, massive scale. And it's not only solar energy, it's also wind energy that has caused the loss of lives of millions and millions of birds. In fact, in his talk that he delivered a couple of years ago, this man, Michael Schellenberger, raised a crucial question. He asked, in the effort to save the climate, are we destroying the environment? That's something I think about a lot, and I think you should think about too. Now, I'm not completely ruling out renewables, of course. In fact, renewables may just be what will change the game. But when the narrative is so fixed, and media and public attention is so fixated on something like renewable energy in this case, we limit and sometimes even block the possible exploration into other possible, in this case, possibly cleaner, better sources of energy, like perhaps nuclear energy, right? And so the path forward lies in areas of innovations that don't necessarily always make the headlines, but have the power to transform industries. Let me give you an example. Drones, right? Now, drones are miniature marvels because they actually have the potential to completely revolutionize urban deliveries. And their speed and efficiency and their ability to deliver lightweight packages actually have the massive potential of mitigating the impact that growing urban population has on climate change. Another one is regenerative agriculture. And this one's particularly close to my heart because I believe it affirms with and aligns with my belief that in this fight against climate change, not only do we have to focus on sustainability, but we also have to focus on healing the earth itself. And tech advancements and technology in regenerative agriculture have helped tap into its potential of carbon sequestration and soil storage on a massive scale, and hence tap into its potential of helping battle the climate crisis. And it's not only these things, it's also, you know, solar-powered fabric and tidal and wave energy systems and 3D printed coral reefs and man-made sea creatures that can capture carbon from oceans and so much more. And then there's AI. Artificial intelligence. One of the most powerful tools of the 21st century with some of the most pivotal and consequential implications on humanity. And herein lies my personal focus interest, because I strongly, strongly believe in the potential that AI holds in completely changing the climate game. And it's already being used in mind-boggling ways in climate change. For example, weather prediction, right? AI's ability, its scale, its speed, and its efficiency is obviously unparalleled and is hence its greatest asset. And so this is being used by many people around the world, this power of AI to analyze large amounts of data and use this data in weather prediction with unheard of before accuracy. And this is being used in so many ways. For example, the IKI project is a project that uses this awesome power of AI to actually help small marginalized communities in rural areas mitigate the growing impact of climate change. And this is especially crucial, things like weather prediction, as global temperatures rise and extreme weather events become more and more frequent. Another example is companies actually using the power of AI to decarbonize industries. That's right, they analyze data produced by other companies and other undertakings. Not only do they use this data to calculate and report emissions of these companies, but they also use it to consult these companies on how to decarbonize. And AI is being used in so many more ways. It's being used to map the impact of deforestation, to stop illegal deforestation, to map icebergs melting, to in battery technology, to reduce ocean pollution and water pollution and air pollution, to reduce energy consumption, and so much more. And so that's my input on the situation. And while I believe, of course, that climate change is being changed in so many ways, I strongly foster the belief that we as a youth, we stand at the helm of this movement, leading the change. And this is a matter of our future, and no one is going to, or is going to even want to save it except for us. And while we understand this on a deeper, deeper level, our approach to actually tackling the issue has to be systematic and objective, right? Which is why I urge all of you here today who are interested in STEM, in science, in technology, in mathematics, use your interests, harness your interests, things you love to learn about, to make changes in industries and sectors that aren't brought up in climate conversations. And if you're not interested in STEM, well, talk to your friends, talk to your peers, talk to your family, work to educate, to inspire, to combat misinformation, to change the climate narrative. Because changing the narrative can help shift entire industries and sectors towards more sustainable practices. And I strongly believe that every field has a role. So harness whatever passions you have to not only change your future, but to change all of ours. As we stand at the crossroads of the climate crisis, I urge you to rethink what climate action really looks like. Because we as a youth hold the power to shift this narrative. Thank you.